interesting. I think you did like analysis. First, of course, the multi-movement piece, you know, the book of keyboards, you know, like it kind of started as a pedagogical exercise, you know, for Philippe Manoury, but it turned into one of the real important pieces for us for the end of the 20th century. Have you seen a sixxen before? I don't know if you're familiar with this instrument. So a sixxen is called a sixxen because there's six of them, and it's one instrument but made out of six instruments. And Zen is for Yannis Zenakis, who invented the instrument and named it after himself, because Zenakis. The interesting thing about the sixxens is that it's microtonally tuned. So you get this really weird thing between timbre and pitch that kind of intersect and make like this weird way of like hearing sounds. It's a very unique instrument. So just for a quick demonstration, you're going to play the first note on each one of them, and you're going to see that they're out of tune. And they get like almost half a step between the lowest note in there and the lowest note in here. So when you play them together, the kind of clashing of these frequencies generates a really interesting effect, which is what Manoury, who was very, you know, friendly and familiar with Zenakis, wrote this piece for. So just play the first note. You see, it goes up a little bit, they're not perfectly tuned. That's on purpose, for a change. So yeah, so these are the sixxens, and Manoury uses them like in a very interesting way. He worked a lot with electronics, and you can hear a lot of electronic treatment in his music. Also, like, he uses the marimba in a very different way. You know, like two of the movements are for marimbas, four hands, 16 mallets, two marimbas, and two gongs that kind of give the bass, two gong players who give like the bass, you know, like a tom to it. And interesting things happen with pitch also when you have 16 mallets playing on the marimba at the same time. You know, 16 note chords on the marimba, they'll be a really good exercise for ear training, I would think. But it becomes timbre the same way, it becomes color, it becomes a very colorful thing. One of the movements is the marimba duo. It's just one of the hardest marimba duos you can have in the repertoire. And the very interesting thing with that piece, again, it's like eight mallets, two players, you know, like playing these hyper fast things. They're very independent, but then they have like these notes, which are absolutely dead together. Which is, you know, first really hard to do, but it also like gives the effect of a third marimba player that's like in the middle, that's unified, you know, the two ones. So you're creating like this phantom player through. And then I have a vibraphone solo that I'll be playing. And the vibraphone solo, what it does is, you know, usually when you play music, you have silence, and then you have notes that get added into that silence. So now what happens if you play every note of the instrument at once? Wow, like all at one time. And then you start to dampen, to take notes out. So what you end up having is like this, you know, like negative space, you know, like in music where notes are extracted, pitches are taken out of the resonance, and then you're left with other ringing pitches. Yeah, this was a lot of fun to put together. I hope you enjoy it. Leave the clavier if you need. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.